this video, we saw how to model a robot. But how can we practically specify the model of a robot in our code? Let's talk about how to do that with URDF, SDF, SRDF, and/or XACRO files. Stay tuned! We saw in a previous video that the model of a robot is nothing but a kinematic chain of rigid links connected by joints. Kinematic because we studied the motion of the robot without considering the cause of the motion, that's the forces that cause the motion. But how can we express these links and joints in our code? We also have to express some basic physical properties like the total mass of the link, the inertia, that's how the mass is distributed over the link, and the type of joints, their velocity limits, etc. We do that with XML files. An XML, extensible markup language file, if you don't know it, is a data file formatted much like an HTML document, but uses custom tags to define objects and data within each object. But don't worry about it, because we'll see it in practice. There are different XML files used in robotics to encode the model of a robot. Let's start with the most basic and important one, the URDF, Unified Robot Description Format. In the URDF, we can specify the kinematics and basic physics of the robot. The main tags in this XML file are link and joint. For each link element, we specify its name and three child elements, visual, collision, and inertial. Visual contains the visual description of the link. It uses geometric primitives like box, spheres, and cylinders. The origins of these primitives is placed relatively to the link reference frame. A reference frame of an object consists of an abstract coordinate system attached to that object. We can also use more complicated meshes by importing DAE or STL files. We can then specify the material and the color of the link, and we can have multiple visual elements for a single link. The child element collision is similar to the visual description of the link, with the difference that the mesh resolution has to be low. This element is used in fact to detect the collision with other objects and the auto-collision of the robot that usually require a demanding computation. The child element inertia instead describes the mass of the link, so we can specify the center of mass, the total mass, and the inertia tensor matrix, that's how the mass is distributed. Let's see now the joint element. It connects two link elements, a parent link and a child link. The child link frame will coincide with the joint frame. We specify the origins of the joint frame always with respect to the parent link. For each joint element, we specify its name and its type, that can be revolute, prismatic, fixed or floating. We then have other child elements that encode some physical limits and dynamic properties. In the limit element, we have lower and upper rotation translation limits, maximum velocity and effort. In the dynamics element, we can specify a damping and a friction coefficients. We can also specify some transmission and more advanced elements, but this is more advanced and we'll cover it another time with some practical tutorials. Let's now consider a robot manipulator like the KUKA. We have 7 degrees of freedom. So in the URDF, we have to specify the 8 links and 7 joints, and we get a pretty simple URDF file. But let's now consider a robotic hand. In a 5-fingered hand, we have 24 degrees of freedom. And let's assume that we also want to specify a URDF for several variants of the same hand, where we have less fingers and various fingertips and transmission models. We need one file per hand type, per transmission type, and fingertip model, where we'll describe explicitly every link and joint. And since many fingers are the same, we have a lot of redundancy, we have very long files that can get hard to read and maintain. So in this case, we might want to use a XACRO file to simplify the URDF. XACRO, XML macro language, is just a scripting mechanism that enables more modularity and code reuse when defining a URDF model. Once you have a XACRO file, you can easily run a script that gives you the URDF generated from the XACRO file. So, XACRO is just another way of defining a URDF, and it's not an alternative to it. It makes certain things easier. For instance, you can generate a wheel macro and instantiate it 6 times with different parameters to put 6 wheels on your robot, as opposed to copying and pasting the same code 6 times manually. And the same applies for the fingers, for example. And generic code can be put as include to be reused in other files. We'll do some practical tutorials also on this. Let's see now the SRDF file. It stands for Semantic Robot Description Format, and it represents the information about the robot that's not in the URDF file, but it's useful for a variety of applications. The intention is to include information that has a semantic aspect to it. Let's see an example. When a link is specified, the parent joint of that link, if it exists, is automatically included. When a joint is specified, the child link of that joint, which will always exist, is automatically included. When a chain is specified, all the links along the chain, including endpoints, are included in the group. Additionally, all the joins that are parents to included links are also included. This means that joins along the chain and the parent joint of the base link are included in the group. Groups can also be formed by referencing to already defined group names. This defines how the robot moves in its environment, that's the connection to the robot's root link. This defines end effectors. By default, it's assumed that any link of the robot could potentially come into collision with any other link in the robot. This tag disables collision checking between a specified pair of links. There can be many such tags in this file. I want to precise that an SRDF file does not replace URDF and is not an extension of URDF. This is a format for representing semantic information about the robot structure, and a URDF file must exist for this robot as well, where the joints and the links that are referenced are defined. While URDFs are a useful and standardized format, they might lack many features. URDF can only specify the kinematic and dynamic properties of a single robot in isolation. URDF cannot specify the pose of the robot itself within a word. It cannot specify joint loops, that's parallel linkages, and it lacks friction and other properties. Additionally, it cannot specify things that are not robots, such as lights, height maps, etc. To deal with this issue, a new format called the Simulation Description Format, SDF, was created for use in the Gazebo simulator, that's one of the best simulators, to solve the shortcomings of URDF. SDF is a complete description for everything from the world level down to the robot level. It's scalable and makes it easy to add and modify elements. You can create the SDF from URDF using scripts available online and then making some little modifications manually. We'll see also this in another tutorial. Well, that's it for this video and see you next time!
I hope you guys liked it. If so, hit the like button, subscribe, ring that bell so to know when more videos like this are out. It helps us out so much. I'll see you there.